Hey guys, this is Shade Gray with the Black and White review for Puppet Masters Legacy. This is the black part of the review where no spoilers will be given. Now, if you want spoilers, stay for the white review. Puppet Master Legacy. It's an interesting flick. Not going to go into much detail about it right here. Just going to say that it's halfway decent, but it's not the best Puppet Master movie. And I'm just going to say that it's essentially a clip show, and I'll go into more detail about that in the white review. But as I said, it's not bad. There is kind of a little plot premise to bring all the clip show-esque things together, and it does culminate in a subtle but nice twist that probably should have been really apparent from the beginning of the Puppet Master movies, but eh. Who's to say? Anyway, as for what I would rate this, I would give this probably a 4 or 5 out of 9, closer to 4, because this does have some unique and original ideas, and for a clip show movie, it's actually quite good. It's just that you've seen all the scenes before, with the exception of the overhanging plot into all of them. It's, again, a clip show. There's not a whole lot new here, but what is new is worth checking out. So, if you'd like, this is a rent. Now, stay tuned for the white review, but be warned, there are spoilers. All right. This is your final spoiler warning. There will be spoilers about the movie's plot coming up now. So, for those of you who don't like spoilers, please leave. I don't want to hear any complaining about the comments about how I spoiled this incredibly fascinating movie. All right, you have about a grand total of 5 seconds to close the video. 3, 2, 1. Alright, so, Puppet Master Legacy. The driving plot of the movie is that there is a mercenary looking for the secret to destroy the puppets in, and she's willing to kill pretty much anybody and everybody to get in her way. She meets up with Peter from the third movie, who's apparently taking care of the puppets. Yeah, that plot line's getting resolved in this movie. What the hell, right? Peter seems to have gone a little nuts, but that's not really apparent until the end of the movie, and again, we don't really find out what she's looking for until the end of the movie, so sorry for spoiling that so early. Anyway, Toulon left some recorded messages from Peter, and that's where the clip show mentioned in the white review comes in. Essentially, it's chronologically telling you how the movies fit together. First, it's retro. Then it's Puppet Master 3. And then it's 1, 2, 4, 5, and 6. And Curse of the Puppet Master. That's pretty much how the formula of it falls out, with the exception of 2, where the main plot of 2 gets shown more at the end. So, yes, if you watch Puppet Master Legacy, you're essentially watching 8 Puppet Master movies condensed into 1, about an hour and 10-minute movie. It's, again, a pretty good clip show, I will admit. The segments showing the clips from the various other movies are a tad bit long, and they can be a tad bit boring because you want to know what all this is leading up to. But again, it's a pretty decent clip show, and this is a good way of kind of introducing yourself to the Puppet Master series, because whereas you do see the main plot of most of these movies, you don't really have any idea what the hell some of these guys are talking about. Like, for example, it doesn't really go in too deep about who's the what the threat is in Puppet Master 6. It doesn't really go into detail about what was going on in Curse of the Puppet Master. I think I said Puppet Master 6, but I meant Retro Puppet Master, who the problem was there. And it doesn't go into much detail about the war the puppets went into in Puppet Masters 4 and 5. It also only kind of vaguely mentions the driving reason that Toulon decided to go against the Nazis in Puppet Master 3. So again, it's a good way of kind of introducing yourself to the Puppet Master movies with an overhanging plot that needs more explaining by watching the other movies. So yes, as you can see, there are a lot of things good about this movie. The only bad parts are it doesn't have much new to introduce to the Puppet Master formula. The puppets really don't do anything in the new scenes. They're just kind of hanging around. The only real thing that they do is Pinhead throws a hammer at the mercenary lady, knocking her down. Yeah, that's about it, to be completely honest. Otherwise, it's just Six Shooter and Jester kind of hanging out. Blade doing some little awkward motion things. And Peter playing tapes and the mercenary wielding a gun. It's an interesting plot. And when you learn that she's not actually looking how to bring them to life, it also reveals something about Toulon. Remember, in the last... In Puppet Master 2. There we go. In Puppet Master 2, Toulon was trying to mess with soul transference. That was another point that was brought up in Puppet Master Curse of the Six, Curse of the Puppet Master. That really didn't get touched on, and that kind of gets shown up here. Essentially, what this movie alludes to at the end is Toulon was messing around with soul transference to try and figure out how to transfer his body, or his mind and his soul, into a more permanent body without the restrictions of the puppets. Now, what this essentially leads to is that the people that Toulon experimented on to try and figure out how to transfer his soul into that wooden body in with human organs in it in Puppet Master 2, apparently those experiments hired this bitch to figure out how to kill themselves. And surprise twist at the end of the movie, Peter shoots the gun at the camera, implying that the creatures, Toulon's experiments in soul transference, were actually in the Bodega Bay. I think that's where this is supposed to be. I'm not sure. That's where it starts out. But yes, it does kind of wrap up the Puppet Master saga pretty well. And yes, this is quote-unquote technically the final Puppet Master movie. Now, that's pretty much all of the plot in this movie, all of the original plot. The mercenary comes, she finds a journal, she shoots the kid from 4 and 5, which we don't actually get to see her do. Then she finds Peter, who's working on the puppets. Peter plays the tapes for her. Peter then gets her on the ground and shoots her and kills her. She admits that she's being hired by the experiments in order to figure out how to kill them. And then Peter shoots at the camera. So I really don't have anything else to talk about. So here's what we're going to do for about the next 2 minutes. I'm going to talk about what I want as the quote-unquote next Puppet Master movie. I'm aware that there's like three after this one, but not chronologically. Chronologically, this is what I want. I want a movie with Peter. I want a movie where he is scared crapless because of these abominations of God that are trying to kill him. That's what I want from the next Puppet Master movie. I want to see these experiments that Toulon did in Soul Transference, and I want to see the puppets fight them. That sounds like a cool premise for a Puppet Master movie, showing the good and bad sides of Toulon. That is a good premise. But that's really all that I have to say. As for rating this movie, as I mentioned in the white review... No, this is the white review. As I mentioned in the black review, I would give this in between a 4 or a 5, because there's not really much original, but it is done well. Full Moon knows how to make cheap budget stuff, and this was a really big cheap budget movie, because there's a lot reused in this. More than 6, but it's done a lot better than Curse of the Puppet Master. So, that's really all I have to say for this. The legacy has now been told of the Puppet Master movies. See what I did there? Unfortunately, Full Moon continues to release Puppet Master movies, so we have a grand total of 3 more to do. Those being the Christmas special. Yes, there's a Christmas special of these movies. And the 2 new ones that Full Moon has released within the last 2 years. So we will be doing those next month. Well, okay, we will be doing the Christmas special next month. Anyway, I am Shade Gray. I hope you have enjoyed this black and white review. This has been Puppet Master Legacy, and I bid you all good evening. Wait for the credits. Show some respect for the people who made this movie. Now, this is me signing off. Peace.